Well, not quite. You see, the MSI GE76 Raider, or is it the Raider GE76, however you want to call it, is not your run-of-the-mill laptop. It costs as much as a used car, and is the showpiece for Intel's latest Alder Lake Hedge and NVIDIA's RTX 3080Ti graphics. There's a lot going on for the Raider GE76, so let's check it out without further ado. You see, MSI did a design rejig back in early last year with the GE76 Raider 10UH. The 12UH version this year carries forward the same design with an aluminum lid, palm rest, small hinges, and a somewhat reduced thickness but still weighing about 3 kilos. Oh, and you also get an RGB light bar for, you know, the added bling. As is common with most MSI Raider laptops, the Raider GE76 offers a smorgasbord of ports. The SD card reader is of the slower variety, but hey, you have one just in case. The Rare offers a handful of useful ports, including mini display out, HDMI 2.1 out for 4K 120 or 8K 60 video, an Ethernet port, and Thunderbolt 4. This year, MSI does not offer a SteelSeries branded keyboard, but the typing is quite comfortable with deep travel and good feedback. This is how it sounds. For a laptop this big, the touchpad is quite small. The tracking is smooth, but the clicks are somewhat loud. The integrated webcam is a 1080p unit, which is a good thing, but color reproduction and sharpness leave a lot to be desired. Opening the back panel requires you to remove 13 Phillips screws. Once you do that, you can pry open the back panel with some effort. Inside, you will find the swappable killer Wi-Fi card, dual channel DDR5 RAM, dual NVMe Samsung SSDs, along with a 99.99 watt-hour battery and a dual fan 6 heat pipe Cooler Boost 5 cooling system. The killer Wi-Fi card supports the latest Wi-Fi 6E standard. Although our Netgear router does not support 6E, we could still get very good throughput. The consistency is not too shabby either. The Raider GE76 features a 17.3-inch 1080p 360Hz panel. The overall performance of the panel is decent. The color accuracy can be further improved with our calibration routine, which you can download for free from our review. Overall, the panel covers a good 94% of sRGB and about 65% of the Adobe RGB color gamuts. It is not a content creator's dream display, but gamers should be able to get by just fine given the low response times and practically no PWM. The Core i9-12900HK is the flagship Alder Lake Hedge processor with 14 cores and 20 threads. It offers boost clocks of up to 5 GHz on the P core and up to 3.8 GHz on the E core. The processor is multiplier unlocked and offers very good overclocking potential. MSI offers several performance modes to choose from, and we went with the extreme performance mode to get the maximum out of the hardware. This basically gives you a PL1 of about 110 watts and a PL2 of about 135 watts. Multi-core performance sustains fairly well in a Cinebench R15 loop test. The laptop is anywhere between 23 to 30% faster than what we've seen with a desktop class Core i9-11900K Rocket Lake CPU. However, we see about 19% lower scores in IDA 64 compared to the 11900K system. Needless to say, system performance and responsiveness are not an issue with the Raider GE76. DPC latency, however, is somewhat on the higher side, so you may run into hiccups during real-time audio or video production. There are two Samsung PM9A1 PCIe NVMe SSDs of 2TB each in our test unit. We measured excellent sequential reads, however, we did notice the drive experiencing significant throttling after a few runs in our disk SPD read loop test. With the Raider GE76, the RTX3080Ti can fully flex its muscles with 175 watts of unhindered power. While that is good on paper, we observed that the performance uplift from an RTX 3080 laptop GPU is not really that high. Stress testing with The Witcher 3 shows a slight dip in frames, but it is not much to worry about. Gaming performance is needless to say excellent. Though our device featured only a 1080p display, it is possible to play most modern titles at 4K 60fps on this card. And as with most gaming laptops, noise still remains a cause for concern. We recommend using the balanced mode if you'd like to keep the noise levels below 50 dBA. That being said, MSI's Cooler Booster 5 seems to be doing a pretty good job in maintaining low surface temperatures. We recorded less than 45 degrees Celsius average at the top and less than 50 degrees Celsius average at the bottom. The onboard speakers are loud and can reproduce the mids and the highs pretty well. The bass, of course, isn't as thumping. The included 280 watt power adapter should be sufficient to power all workloads. Overall power consumption is quite high given the hardware inside, but it is still better than its rivals. Well, needless to say, battery life isn't the Raider GE76 Forte. So here's the thing. MSI continues to position the Raider GE76 as a benchmark for enthusiast gaming laptops, and we see that it does not disappoint. A premium quality construction and the performance to match makes the Raider GE76 stand apart from the crowd for quite some time to come. It may cost as much as a used car, but it does perform like one you would want to covet. We hope you enjoyed this video summary of our Raider GE76 review. Check out the full review on notebookcheck.com and notebookcheck.net for more information. Thanks for watching and see you soon.